Hi, and welcome to this video tutorial on the Darf header in the PMB Investigational Drug Accountability Series. This video will review the process for completing the header of both the original and oral NCI Darf. There are two drug accountability record forms, the original Darf and the oral Darf. You see the original Darf at the top of the screen and the oral Darf underneath it. Darfs must be maintained to track the disposition of all study supplied agents for NCI clinical trials. Both DARFs are available on the CTEP website at http://ctep.cancer.gov/forms. The header is the top section of the DARF above the agent transaction area. All fields must be completed on every page. The headers of the original DARF and oral DARF contain the same information with two exceptions. The oral DARF contains areas to include the local protocol number and the bottle size. Unless specifically stated, the information provided applies to both the original DARF and the oral DARF. Note that the form has an expiration date located in the upper right-hand corner. Once the expiration date has passed, do not start a new page without verifying it is the current form on the CTEP website. In the event the current form on the website is expired, continue to use it until an updated form is posted. The header information can be typed before the DARF is printed or handwritten after printing. Please note the font size will automatically adjust based on the number of characters in the field. Anything handwritten must be legible. Okay, now let's begin reviewing the header. The first area to complete is the page number and record type. The DARF templates do not allow for inclusion of a page number. It must be handwritten in after printing. Check the box indicating if this is a control or satellite record. Under the name of the institution, write out the name, avoiding abbreviations if possible. For agent name, include all names on the shipping receipt. While not required, add the NSC number. Then add the protocol title. Long titles can be abbreviated, but not to the point the protocol is unidentifiable or could be confused with another trial. For the investigator name, include the first and last name. This is especially important with common last names such as Smith. Add the CTEP investigator number. Note that a separate DARF is required for each ordering investigator. Next is the NCI protocol number. The NCI protocol number is required. The local protocol number is optional on both the original and oral DARF. If a local protocol number is assigned, it can be added to the original or oral DARF. Next, identify the dispensing area. This is the location where the agent is stored. Under dose form and strength, record the agent, strength, and formulation in this field. For injectable preparations, include the concentration and volume per vial. For example, 200 mg per 8 ml vial, 25 mg per ml. Here's an example of a completed original DARF header. Next, we will review the oral DARF header. There are two items specific to the oral DARF, the local protocol number. If there's no local number, leave the space blank or write in NA, and bottle size. Add the number of tablets, capsules, etc. If this is a liquid preparation, indicate the concentration and total volume per container. Here's an example of a completed oral DARF header. The DARF with a completed header may now be printed. If the appropriate software is available, the form may be saved for future use. To learn more about the difference between control and satellite dispensing, refer to Section 5.3 of the Audit Guidelines or the August 2013 issue of the PMB newsletter. Thank you for watching this video tutorial. Additional PMB Investigational Drug Accountability videos are available through our YouTube playlist. Please note that the video and any items displayed within the videos are subject to change. Check back periodically for updates. Questions can be directed to the Pharmaceutical Management Branch, CTEP NCI, by phone Monday through Friday, 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time, or by email at any time.